Hello again, everyone. Edwin Lerner back once again. In this YouTube astrological segment, I'm going to be talking about Sagittarius enemies. And yes, this does apply and pertain to the sun, moon, and ascendant. Well, anyway, people, first thing is when I look at enemies for a zodiac sign, I look at the sign on the cusp of the seventh house. And the sign on the cusp of the seventh house in a solar or natal chart for Sagittarius is Gemini. Now, this could simply be somebody that has a Gemini sun, moon, or ascendant, or simply somebody that embodies Gemini-like characteristics. It could be people that are rather flippant, fickle, flighty, very changeable, mercurial people, people that are loquacious, that are fast talkers, that really are very street savvy and street smart. It also could be people that are conniving as well. And it could also be people that are simply in a Gemini-like profession or vocation, such as someone in a communications field like data or satellite communications. It could be somebody that might be in writing and journalism, people that are in fields that require strong use of the hands, dexterity, such as auto or refrigeration mechanics. So anyway, and the thing about, it's interesting, these two signs could be very similar. They're both, of course, mutable signs, both very adaptable and pliable. But where I think the biggest disparity between these two signs are is the fact that Sagittarius is often very voracious and is really strongly about the truth. They speak the veritable truth often, whether you want to hear it or not. Gemini will often speak their own truth, and Gemini, it's generally not malicious, but Gemini, a lot of times they'll say something where it may not be 100% truthful, but it's done in a way where they don't want to hurt the other person's feelings. And the thing about Sagittarius, they're often very like upright in terms of being lawful. And you look at the Gemini, now Gemini, most Geminis are as well, I'm sure, but Gemini, you'll see some Geminis where they'll, you know, they'll say, well, the ends justify the means, even if it's not something 100% lawful. They'll say, well, gee, I did this to facilitate the economy. So you'll see, Gemini's a little bit more lean that way as opposed to Sagittarius, and that's why you have the big disparity. Gemini often will learn things superficially, though very quickly. Sagittarius is more inclined toward broad subjects. Now, getting to the 12th house cusp of hidden adversaries or hidden enemies, well, Scorpio often falls on that for Sagittarius. And this could either be somebody that has, as far as a solar or natal chart goes. Now, this could either be somebody that is a Scorpio sun, moon, or ascendant, or simply somebody that embodies Scorpio-like characteristics. It could be people that are very surreptitious, very sneaky, people that are about manipulation, people that also can be very powerful, very intense emotionally, and really these people, and also very controlling people. Now, the thing about this is you look at this and, well, some people will ask, well, why you have a, why is the sign on the 12th house cusp, how would that relate to a hidden enemy? And the theory I have behind that is the fact that, I mean, it's what the sign that's on the 12th house cusp often can be those characteristics that we have difficulty seeing in ourselves that remain hidden to us to some degree. Now, and so I think for that reason, we might, maybe those people that are represented by the sign on the 12th house cusp can be hidden to us. Now, the thing about this is you look at the, you know, why would Scorpio in many cases be that hidden adversary for Sagittarius? Well, Sagittarius, I mean, the first thing I look at is going back to Scorpio can be rather, I mean, the sign itself could be rather surreptitious, rather sneaky, and sometimes subtle. And you look at Sagittarius, almost the exact opposite. They could be very blunt, very voracious. I mean, they're just not, they speak their veritable truth and can be downright tactless. So I can understand why they might that might form Scorpios as hidden enemies or people that embody those characteristics, because it's just a disparity of how they go about different things. And another thing too is that Sagittarius is often very religious, and I'm not saying, all Scorpio people aren't, but Sagittarius more on average than Scorpio. And Scorpio may often get involved like with the supernatural or the occult. And the thing is, there are certain religions where they'll rebuke, that kind of studying those subjects or that belief in those subjects. So I understand why Scorpio could be a hidden enemy for Sagittarius. Now, keep in mind, people, that hidden enemy, I mean, sorry, adversaries or enemies are not limited to, I mean, I don't see them as limited to the seventh house and 12th house cusp, because the enemies could be people who you are very incompatible with in those two signs. Of course, they're square. Sagittarius by sign are Virgo and Pisces. Now, with Virgo, and we get to the blunt thing again with Sagittarius. Virgo can often be very tactful, very diplomatic. Sagittarius often won't think before they say things. Virgo will often analyze something to death before they say it, and therefore they wind up being more tactful and diplomatic than Sagittarius. And Virgo is often overly pedantic, wordy, very verbose, and Sagittarius often just gets right to the heart of the matter. They go about things different ways. Virgo will analyze something for a while with their work, doing some project, and Sagittarius thinks, well, I'm just going to go do this and get it done quicker. But Sagittarius may often overlook those essential details. Also, Virgo can be an incessant worrier. Why Sagittarius is really very worry-free often. And I think that's where you see some of the disparities. And also, Virgo, even though they're more tactful and diplomatic than Sagittarius on average, they could also be incessant complainers and be very critical of Sagittarius. And Sagittarius will let them know very bluntly that they don't really want to hear it in many instances. Now, Pisces could be very incompatible and can wind up being an enemy as well. I mean, Sagittarius again, I mean, their bluntness can flat out really hurt very sensitive, emotional Pisces people. Pisces might be too passive for Sagittarius. Sagittarius is a little bit more of a doer, I think, than Pisces. Sagittarius is often really about being adventurer and being more outdoorsy. While Pisces is more about staying inside, they could often be very reclusive, and really they go into their own fantasy world often, where Sagittarius will deal a little bit more with reality. Sagittarius could be very voracious and truthful, while Pisces can be a little bit deceptive, and they're not nearly as confrontational as Sagittarius can be, who's basically, I mean, they're really generally not afraid to say much to anybody. So, anyway, well, let's go to Sagittarius as an enemy. What can they do? Well, they might make jokes about you. They might publicly demoralize some in terms of, maybe making their jokes about that person. And also, maybe they'll even publish something that might be it might be humorous about their enemy, that they can make a joke about them, but it'll put them down though in the process. And I say publishing because, of course, Sagittarius is associated with publishing. Now, and I'm being facetious about this, people. If Sagittarius is an enemy, well, maybe you could publicly denounce their philosophies and beliefs. Be more learned in a subject than they are. Have greater maybe high school, I'm sorry, college credentials than Sagittarius. And really, anyway, people, that'll conclude this YouTube astrological segment for Sagittarius enemies. Stay tuned next time, where I'm going to be talking about, in my opinion, the worst synastry aspects in astrology. Two things I want to get with you on before I head out. Firstly, the stars may impel, but do not compel. And secondly, never isolate any single astrological element, aspect, planetary placement, position, configuration, influence, or what have you, and make an analysis of a person, astrologically speaking, based on this alone, because astrologically speaking, the person is the sum of all their components in their natal chart and not just one. Until next time, people, stay well.